North West Leicestershire, 99.2 Hermitage FM.
Yes, with John Sinclair and Kevin Gaughan, it's the local music show for the next 55 minutes. We're going to play something by the Del Sharrons, but the guest we're expecting is not quite here yet. Maybe he's having trouble finding it. That does happen.
It does, doesn't it? Yes.
Or he's running late, or his car doesn't work.
Perhaps it all could be anything.
Have you got his phone number?
No.
That's good. Anyway, maybe they'll appear, but we're going to talk about Scam before that, because they're having a few problems at the moment. They've had to postpone some of their, or cancel some of their gigs, haven't they?
Yeah, unfortunately, I don't quite know exactly what's gone on, but I gather Matt, the bassist, rather wonderful bassist, and really good showman, actually, in the band, he's got some problems, or there's some health problems in the family, so unfortunately they've had to cancel their forthcoming gigs, which includes a Leicester one. Which is a bit unfortunate.
Which one was that, the O2?
Yes.
Yeah, of course that was a big gig for them as well, wasn't it?
Yeah. And of course, Scam, of course, are one of Leicester's favourite, longest going rock bands, really, aren't they?
And they're the ones that brought us together, because you remember I did an interview with them when they played at the Musician, and they came into the studio at a previous radio station of mine and said, oh, you ought to link up with that Kevin Gaughan guy.
Yeah.
And here we are because of that.
That's it, it's all their fault.
So it's all thanks to them. I can see somebody that looks like carrying a guitar walking towards the building. You look around there.
That's a bit weird.
It's probably got nothing to do with it. It might be, actually. It's actually Flying Kangaroo Alliance. Mm-hmm. It is. They're arriving early, so we could get them on first. So that might happen. Anyway, it's a bit of Scam before that. Why are you shaking your head at me?
Because I recognise the ladies. It's the Del Shannons.
Oh, it is the Del Shannons.
Two of them. Ooh. So they've actually going slightly up in our opinion.
Yeah. That's Scam and The Wire. And it's a shame they're having to kind of like cancel some of their concerts, but they have got kind of personal problems, so we wish them all well.
Oh, I love that track, John, don't you?
That's good. It's very, very good. And yeah, they were good in concert as well, weren't they? In session, almost.
As always. Always put on a really good show, they do. Fantastic to watch. But it's a little bit unfortunate to hear not only are they cancelling the future shows because of what we're just saying about Matt's family, but also the drummer as well. Unfortunately, X-Ray's leaving them by the looks of it.
It's a real shame because they're obviously one of the top bands in Leicester, aren't they?
So. Yeah. But Steve, the lead guitarist, assures me that the band will go on. So I hope so, because they are one of Leicester's biggest rock bands. They've been around for ages and they've been doing some big things, and they are getting really well known because they're supporting some really good tours these days around the country.
So if you've got a ticket for their O2 gig, then they're not going to be doing that. While that was playing, I'm pleased to say two members of the Del Sharrons have arrived, Ryan, John Smith and Sharon, and we'll talk to them after playing this track. This is called Tear Me Up.
Tremble like a little old pup when you put your arms around me. Well, baby, you tear me up. I just wanna know if you love me too, 'cause if you leave me now, don't know what I'll do. I'm so in love that I can hardly speak. My hands are shaking and I'm feeling weak. So won't you consider my feelings? Don't take advantage. Every time you kiss me, I tremble like a willow bud. When you put your arms around me, well, baby, you tear me up. I just wanna join if you love me too. 'Cause if you leave me now, I don't know what I'll do. So in love that I can hardly speak. My hands are shaking and I'm feeling you. So won't you consider my plea?
I was just saying to the band that I go rock and roll nights on a Tuesday in Leicester, and that will go down very well, I have to say. That's the Del Sharrons and Tear Me Up, and Kevin's got them next to him to talk to them.
That was just a ticket, wasn't it? Yeah, welcome, good chaps. And if you'd like to introduce yourselves and what you do in the band.
Well, I'm the lead singer, Sharon, and this is Ryan.
Hello, I'm the lead guitarist and one of the backing vocalists.
Ah, hello, Ryan. You know, you told us to call you Ryan John Smith, is that right?
Yes, so, I like to use my full name.
Bit of a mouthful, though. Can we abbreviate that? RJS, something like that?
I've thought of that, yeah. It's came across my mind, definitely.
Okay, but all right. Ryan John Smith, hello. Welcome. So, yeah, so you're Sharon. Oh, is that how the band got its name, then?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
From my name and... Del Shannon.
Yeah, Del Shannon's a big rock and roll artist, yeah. You're probably too young to remember that, Kevin.
Oh, very nice of you to say so,
and
but
a lot
yes.
of rock and roll bands have, like, the Del some things at the start, like the Del right. Vikings and things, so it kind of all...
Hence the Del bit. Excellent, yeah. Yeah. So obviously your genre is, like, 50s, 60s sort of music, isn't it? How did that come about?
Well, for me, it was my dad's interest in the music itself, the rock and roll sort of era and all of that. So I got into it from a very young age. Started off by listening to like Buddy Holly, Elvis, people like that. And it sort of progressed from there, really.
So did you start singing at that sort of age, or did that come later?
Yeah, I've been singing from a very, very young age.
Did you learn to do the dancing first, though? Because obviously the dancing part of it is quite popular, isn't it?
I actually learned to do the dancing after.
Did you?
Yeah. Oh, <okay. laughs> But you sort of...
We get your dad to teach you, did you? That sort of thing.
Yeah, yeah.
Because I used to say to guys, I used to say, practice with the door handle. Pretend the door handle's the lady.
Yeah,
I think on a film called That Would Be the Day, which you're probably too young to remember.
Oh, I've actually
remember that?
Seen that, yeah.
And I think the Ringo Starr or somebody is practicing on the door. Yeah. It's quite good, actually.
Wow, that's interesting.
So you do the dancing and everything then, so
yeah.
That sounds like quite a show. Unfortunately, one of the few bands I haven't seen locally. But having said that, though, I don't think there are many 50s or 60s bands around locally. You're the in fact, I think this is a debut, isn't it? You're the first 50s, 60s genre band we've had on the show.
Indeed.
Am I right?
Wow. Yeah, we've not been going. Yeah.
Congratulations.
But actually, that's quite refreshing in a way. I mean, what made you decide? Did you kind of just one of you? How did you find each other? Because there's five of you all together, isn't there?
Yeah. Well, basically, the band started as a three-piece. There was me and the bass player, Scott, and our old drummer, Steve. And we sort of quickly started growing and getting a reputation and... We sort of decided then, right, we need a lead guitarist. So we incorporated Brett, who's still with us now, on lead guitar. But our drummer left, and the lead guitarist became our drummer. And then we saw you advertised on... What website was it?
Join My Band, and it was actually the sound engineer who got in touch with me, Matt Collins, like the best sound engineer I've ever worked with, in my opinion. Yeah, it was him who got in touch with me, and it was like, oh, I'm after a lead guitarist, and I jumped at the chance when I found out it was rock and roll, because it was the music that I loved.
And you've got the look as well, the slick back hair. I used to have hair like that back in the day. Yeah. And obviously you've got the stripy top, and you wear the outfits, don't you?
Yeah, I do. I even make the skirts as well myself, so...
It's a good look, though. You kind of... Everybody in the band, I guess, does that, don't they? Kind of interested in the
part? Most of them... Well, I say most of them. The bass player, he's got really long hair and kind of looks more like Bon Jovi, but... But Matt, our sound engineer, he's recently become our backing vocalist as well. Very talented.
Yeah. Is that when you became a fifth piece?
Yeah, that's when we became...
Because you used to be a four-piece, didn't you?
Yeah. So we incorporated him and...
So he does the quiff thing.
Yeah, he's got the whole quiff, the proper quiff going on.
Yeah, the rock and roll night I go to that I mentioned, some of the people just do the whole thing, dress up, leather jackets, all that sort of
stuff. Yeah, drape coat or
something. It was a good era, though, wasn't it?
Yeah.
So as the Del Sharrons, then, do you just do covers or do you do your own stuff as well?
We have started writing our own stuff. Our aim is to write our own stuff eventually, you know, to put out an album of our own material, but... We started off as like a covers band. We're still sort of doing that at the moment, but we're sort of like looking towards getting an album together with some of the songs, like some of yours that you've done on your own, some of mine that I've wrote.
I was going to ask who's kind of the inspiration behind the writing. That's you, then, is it?
Well, I've probably written the most songs at the moment, but Sharon's really good at writing lyrics, and I'm more of a melody kind of guy.
Well, that often works, though. Somebody does the tune, somebody does the lyrics.
Yeah.
And I think the next song's one of yours, isn't it?
Yes, it is. Yeah, it's one I've written before I joined the band. All of them are ones I've written before I joined the band, so...
It's called Mr. Stealth Esteem.
Yes.
Kind of difficult to say at times.
A lot of them are,
So what's the inspiration behind that song, then?
Quite a lot of the songs I've written are all based on the fact that I'm trying to achieve my goal, and my goal is either to achieve happiness or to get through my day, you know, get through day-to-day life.
So what do you do as a regular thing? You working or you've
I'm temporarily working in a warehouse before I join De Montfort University to do mechanical engineering.
And do gigs there?
Hopefully, yeah, it would be nice.
Do you do many gigs in Leicester?
Leicester and,
All over, don't we, really? Right. We've got Mallory Park coming up again. We've just played there recently, and we played in Matlock at their big bike event.
Yeah.
We're playing Wellingborough this weekend at Chester. But, we do have quite a few around the Leicestershire, and we've got one, I think, in Rutland as well.
Yeah.
Now, you brought your guitar with you. Pick up your guitar and, yeah, and give us a little bit of a tune, because maybe you can even sing along. It's a bit kind of, we're throwing it at you a bit, but hey, why not?
I think you should do your Johnny Cash.
Throw me in the deep end,
yeah,
aren't we?
Yeah, go on. I'll let you do that.
Right, okay.
I'm going to turn my mics down.
I hear that train a-coming, it's rolling round the bend. I ain't seen the sunshine since I don't know when. I'm stuck in Folsom prison, and time keeps dragging on. But that train keeps rolling on out of San Antonio. When I was just a baby, my mama told me, son, always be a good boy, don't ever play with guns. But I shot a man in Reno just to watch him die. When I hear that whistle blowing, I hang my head and cry. Well, if they free me from this prison, if that railroad train was mine, I'd better move it on a little farther down the line. Far from Folsom Prison, that's where I want to stay. And I let that lonesome whistle blow my blues away.
Wow.
Thank you.
I really want that film. I wasn't into Johnny Cash originally, but then they made that film about his life.
Yeah, the walk.
I can't remember the actor.
Fantastic film.
But he really got the, I mean, Johnny Cash music now, I kind of really appreciate a lot more.
Yeah.
But that was almost the song that broke him, wasn't it? As well.
Yeah.
Sun Records, wasn't it? With the Elvis label that he signed for originally.
Yeah.
I know my stuff. She's looking at me quite surprised there. But yeah, good rendition as well.
Yeah.
I want to clap again.
Yeah. Yeah. Thank you.
Okay, we're going to play another song. So tell us about the song we're going to play next.
Mr. Self-Esteem, like I said, it's one of the many that where I'm trying to achieve a goal. In this particular song, I'm describing the feeling as a person and somebody who I want to meet. So I'm trying to meet the feeling, if that makes sense.
Okay, it'll probably make sense on the song.
It will do, definitely. Thank you.
to say, miss the self-esteem.
There was Sharrons and Mr. Self-Esteem and Sharrons next to me. Just lean in because I managed to get your gigs up on the screen here.
Yep, coming up in September, we've got Saffron Lane Working Men's Club. That's a charity gig for Air Ambulance. We've got one in Rutland, Oakham at the railway. And we've also got International Sidecar Bonanza at Mallory Park, which should be a really good event. We recently played their Bike Bonanza. That was fantastic. So, but all our gigs are on our website, www.delsharrons.co.uk.
And it's Sharrons with two R's. That's the thing to
it remember, is, yeah. Sharrons with two R's. And then you can also check us out on Facebook, Twitter, MySpace, all of those.
Usual
so,
stuff.
Yeah. So, okay. Yeah, feel free to check.
Thanks, Sharon, and thanks to Mr. Ryan John Smith as well. Very good song in the studio. That was a bit of a bonus you bringing a guitar, wasn't it? But, yeah, we'll look forward to seeing you in the fresh, so to speak.
Yeah, should be good.
And no laughing at my rock and roll dancing. I'm fairly good.
Try not to.
My mum taught me, so, yeah, it goes back a bit of a time. Okay, we're going to play a Midnight Wire, then we're going to get somebody from Midnight Wire on the programme, because they've got a gig coming up this Friday. Yep.
Dressed the same, and all the girls wanted was change. They said that love makes the world go round, but where is fine, there's none to be found. Hey! Worked all these years, and all the love it ends in tears. They said that love makes the world go round, but where is mine? There's none to be found. Hey! They dressed the same, and all the girls wanted was change. They said that love makes the world go round, but where is mine? There's none to be found. And all my friends worked all these years, and all the love it ends in tears. They said that love makes the world go round, but where is mine? There's none to be found. We'll be right back.
that's one I've not heard before, actually. Kevin sent that to me earlier. Midnight Wire and Everyone's a Saint. Flying Kangaroo Alliance are next door. We'll talk to them shortly. Before that, a bit of Midnight Wire on the phone. And Kevin, tell us who we got.
We've only gone and got the one and only Mr. Alex Van Roose.
Hey!
Thank you. How are you? How's everyone at Takeover?
Yeah, well, we're not Takeover anymore. This is Hermitage FM in Colville.
Yeah, get your facts right, Alex.
Yeah, yeah, kind
of, sort it out.
We're not doing Takeover.
I'm going mad then.
I never did Takeover anyway.
No. But I think you ought to cut him off.
When you fixed the phone, John.
Did Kevin not mention... Kevin clearly didn't mention that I was here with him. He's always doing that.
He probably has. I've just not had my text properly.
I thought the name of the show might give it away.
It's Colville, there you go. Well, it's the first time for me on FM Colville, so that's always a good thing.
Excellent.
So a gig coming up this Friday. Tell us about it.
Yeah, in fact, we're doing like a stripped down set of our album, really, which will be out on the 13th. But this Friday on the 12th, we're doing like a kind of, stripped back acoustic session, showing our all the tracks off the album. In a very different light. So it's at Pie Bar, which is around Narborough Road area. You should pop down.
Yeah, we're going to, but you've got decent support as well, haven't you?
Yeah, I mean, we've got... trying to think what we've got now. There's been so many bands that we've wanted to get on. I'll pull up all... I'm literally at the studio at the moment. We've been doing demos for our second album, which is also quite exciting. But
for the next one after this one?
I mean, I know Pilot Cities. I know we've got Siobhan Mazzy as well, who's
An
absolutely stunning voice. I'm not actually too sure who else we've got on, but I've been so busy at the moment. I've been trying to keep away from organisation and stuff.
Well, yeah. What day is it, Alex?
It's Friday on the 12th.
No, I know. So, what day is it today?
What day is it today?
I'm just checking. You knew that. Sorry.
Tuesday the 9th.
Thank you.
Tuesday the 9th. just about getting there, you know.
So, Alex, so your album release, that sounds quite interesting, doing it acoustically then. Do all the songs translate acoustically?
Yeah, no, it's, we've been working on getting some stripped-back versions anyway over the last year, and we really like them. It's a very different light to shine our album, I suppose, but it'll be available online on iTunes and Amazon and Play.
What's the thinking about that? Why do an acoustic? Why do an acoustic show?
We're releasing our physical single separately. The reason, we're very proud of this, but we've been doing our whole album ourselves. So right from the word go, all the way up through everything. Set up a record label to do it. We've got all the radio plugging and the PR work kind of starting in November for the release of all the singles. But the physical copies will be available in November. And our big kind of launch and everything will be around November, where we'll have all the projections.
Well, we'll have to get you in the studio.
Live show.
Yeah, we'll have to get you in the studio around then, and you can come in and we can play some tracks as well. That'd be good.
Definitely. We'll make sure you get a full copy anyway, fairly soon, actually. It'll probably be the start of next week, but we've got it available online so that people can actually buy it and listen to it. A massive thing, I think, for our album launch, it'd be great for everyone to know the songs before they come.
Yeah, sure.
Because there are some new songs, there are some old songs on there, so it'd be great for everyone to have a bit of a taste of it before we do our huge kind of big show. But we wanted to play something, and so I think it's great that we're doing an acoustic session, kind of showing a different way of the album.
Okay, we'll have to leave it there, but thanks for coming on, Alex, and and Kevin will be there bopping away on Friday. Probably.
Fantastic.
Yeah, look forward to it.
Okay, Alex, thanks very much indeed.
Okay, well, see you both soon.
Yep, that's Alex then, from Midnight Wire. Coming up next in the studio will be Flying Kangaroo Alliance, they're waiting outside, so let's play a track from them. This is called Drunk.
Smarter.
There you go, that's Drunk. I've known that a long time. That's Flying Kangaroo Alliance, and there are three of them in the studio. I've got a list here. Ali, Mary and Keely, welcome to the show.
Hello.
All gathered around one microphone, but kind of make it work. But the reason you're here is because you're playing at Oxjam.
We are indeed.
So did they approach you? Ali, how did that kind of work?
They did approach us, yeah. I don't know, we accidentally fall into things, really, with our band. But I think it's more of a case of we work really hard, so we put ourselves out there, and I think people respond to that.
And you do as well, don't you? Yeah. You play a lot on the local music
Absolutely.
Scene all the time.
We played Oxjam a couple of years ago, just me and Mary, as just like kind of an acoustic set. We kind of always hoped that it would be a full band at some point, and yeah, there you go.
And Mary, I think I last saw you at the Pie Bar in Leicester, and it was... quite a raucous gig. You were really into it that night.
Yeah,
which is good. I guess you've got to, though, haven't you, really?
I can't remember when that was. People talk to me about gigs and then, you know...
They all nose together.
Yeah, for me, it's not as memorable, each one. But, yeah, I remember you being there. Can't remember which gig it was. Might have been my birthday. Was it my birthday?
Yeah, it was the Pie Bar,
that
anyway.
That would have been
yeah.
raucous.
I do remember where it was.
Was that a solo one? Because you play solo as well, don't
that
you?
That was a full band.
No, that was
yeah,
a full band.
I do,
it was
yeah.
a full band because I remember Ali coming up and not buying me a drink.
Oh, John. Oh, sorry, mate.
And, I owe you one. And Keely, you're not the quiet one, are you?
I'm not the quiet one. No.
Oh, good.
You've obviously not met me enough.
I don't think I've talked to you before. So tell us about how did you come together, the band?
I was the last one to join the band.
Right,
Ali, Mary, and our recent drummer, Ivan, all were trying out together. Got drunk one night with basically Mary and Ivan. I went, I'll be your bassist. Kicked Ali off the bass, and now he's lead guitarist, and that was it.
And you do a few vocals as well, don't you?
Yeah, I try. I just scream a bit in the background.
Oh, you weren't screaming. I thought you were quite melodic. Did she often say that, Ali? Is that what she says?
Yeah. She doesn't give herself enough credit. She's a massive part of what we do, so, yeah.
And we're going to play a new track that you sent me, Feel Free. It says here in brackets, First Final Master. So you've obviously been working on this for a while, haven't you?
Yeah, sorry, Mary.
Actually, we recorded it quite a while ago. We recorded two tracks, which were probably a little bit more radio-friendly in the way they were recorded. But the record label that we worked with, Punk Fox, didn't want to put those out. They wanted to do something a bit more raw as our first release.
What's wrong with being radio-friendly?
They wanted to... Basically, we've got a plan that initially it's
got
a lot
plan.
More raw, and then bit by bit we sort of progress from that so that people who are into us from the start can, you know, can see that live.
You can have a radio, yeah, but you can have a radio-friendly single, but you can do a raw version when you do it live, surely?
Absolutely, yeah.
Yeah, I mean, she pulled her nose over there. Is that logic or what? I don't know. Because a lot of bands do that. They tend to do an interpretation when they do it live, don't they?
You can, but one of the nice things that people overhear people saying at gigs is, oh, you know, you must buy this vinyl because it sounds exactly like they do live.
Yeah, okay.
So I think that's really important. I think that's a great place to start from.
Have you ever thought about recording live then?
The single was recorded live, yeah. Apart from the vocals that were recorded afterwards.
Yeah, the track you just played was one of those sessions, so Drunk, yeah.
Okay, so the writing procedure, how does that work?
That'd be Mary.
Is that just you? Is it just Mary?
Well, Mary comes to us with all the songs, so she's the singer-songwriter, hence why she does her own solo stuff. But then we all do our own separate things on top of it, so we all get together.
Yeah, nobody gets told what to do. The beauty of the band is that everybody does what they feel is right.
Is that hence the word alliance at the end of your name?
Yeah, completely. Because
that kind of makes sense, doesn't it, really? Because you're like separate countries like Scotland and England trying to form an alliance when they vote next week.
Yeah, that analogy is brilliant.
That's very nice. The name didn't come from anything and means nothing. But it's lovely that you've made it mean something.
Well, actually, it does now because you're in the alliance because you do separately but you join together.
So now
I'm not sure about
wings.
I'm not sure about the kangaroo bit. To
we
be
need
honest.
Wings and we need little joeys.
Yeah, we need wings and joeys. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. So the recording process was fairly straightforward then, was it? Do you find that process quite easy?
The actual recording was very straightforward. It was losing a wheel on the M69 and having a car crash on the way to doing the vocals that wasn't quite so straightforward.
There's a song there, isn't there?
Yeah, where's the song?
Called Car Crash.
Isn't the motorway song about that sort of stuff?
Oh, the motorway song? No, that's about having a suicidal boyfriend.
Oh dear.
That's a bit different.
Don't go into that. I mean, obviously, Oxjam. Let's talk about Oxjam a bit, because obviously there's a lot going on, and it's a job to get to see everybody you want to see. You kind of appreciate that, yeah. but it's a worthwhile cause, isn't it, as well? So obviously, doing it's not a problem.
Yeah, absolutely, and you know, there's so many bands that play at Oxjam, and everybody just performs for free, and you know, does it all for the basically for charity, which is amazing to have like a whole day festival completely for charity where everyone just gives their time for free. It's amazing.
It's about £10 for a band to go and watch what
the
you
whole,
like or something.
For
yeah.
The whole day, yeah.
Yeah. For the whole day for I don't know how many venues, like 10 venues.
I think it's about 19 venues.
Is there more? Yeah. It's amazing, really.
And it's a really good day out as well, from the gig-goer's perspective. I mean, I have a lot of fun just going in and out all the venues, seeing all the top-quality bands as well. So it's really good.
I was going to ask you what your favourite ever gig was, but given the answer you said about not being able to remember the one I'm talking about...
Yeah, don't ask me. Ask them.
Ali, go on.
Well, a couple of the London ones we've done have been very memorable, but I don't know, really.
Whereabouts in London?
We've played Kilburn. We played a place called The Good Ship, which is amazing. An excellent venue.
Yeah.
We played, King's Cross Water at, so it wasn't
that
so
was
good.
Memorable.
Yeah,
that
was too.
But in a bad way.
I don't know. I mean, with some of the lesser ones.
Shaun and Knife, wasn't it?
Yeah, well, that's right. There you go. Shaun and Knife, when we supported them at The Musician. Oh, that was incredible.
I've never
night,
seen a band
actually.
Smile so much.
Yeah. That was
I guess play, a lot of bands talk about getting a chance to play out of Leicester, because you can get stuck in a kind of a repetition thing, can't you?
Yeah, definitely.
So playing out and getting a different audience must be great.
Yeah. I think one of the last times we met, we were about to play Brighton, I think, when we spoke.
Yeah, well, you were,
ago.
Yeah.
That was a pretty memorable
yeah,
event.
Nice.
Yeah,
good.
Yeah.
I think Keely should tell a small story about Brighton.
Yeah, go on, small story about Brighton.
Well, let's just say the stage was a bit unsteady, and I, instead of falling into the monitor, stepped over the monitor and pushed a whole table with drinks on two gentlemen at the front. They thought I was being rock and roll. I really wasn't. I just fell over.
But it looked rock and roll.
It looked rock and roll.
Yeah. Nice one.
Are you sure it's the stage that wasn't steady? And
it might have been me drinking.
But do you have to settle your nerves a lot before you go on stage then? Is it? I mean, like most performing is kind of like, you know, you get nerves. I mean, even I get nerves.
If we can say alcohol for that reason, then yes.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah, I always get nervous.
A light drink to settle you down, type of thing.
Sometimes. No, I always get nervous, and I've been doing music in different bands and on my own for years, like,
I guess,
know, yeah, 10 years, and I still get nervous every single
I
gig.
I guess any professional band would probably say the same.
I'm the opposite. When I'm with the band, I'm fine. When I play on my own, I get scared as hell.
Yeah, I can imagine, because if you're playing with a band, there's lots of others there on the stage.
I'm a lot more relaxed
with
the
band. If you're on your own, then everybody's looking at you.
Right.
Last time I saw you play, actually, I seem to remember the drummer wasn't too sure if he was going to be leaving or not. But he's clearly not leaving, so that's good.
No, he is, unfortunately.
Oh, he is leaving.
I said that at the beginning.
Yeah, our former drummer.
Yeah. We're currently doing drummer tryouts at the moment, so if any of your listeners are out there...
Are they standing outside?
Yeah, that's a shame.
To lose a founding member of any band is, you know, it's been a bit of a traumatic experience, but... We're really hopeful about what we're going to be doing going forward, and we've got a lot of good things in the pipeline, so we're onwards and upwards as far as we're concerned.
So, any good-looking 20-year-old drummers out there?
So, Mary, tell us about the song we're going to play next, Feel Free. Tell us about that.
Feel Free. Now, do I tell the real story or a different story?
Both.
Okay. Basically, it's about knowing that I was going to break up with somebody, knowing it would be really hard, and it, you know, and I, in the song it sort of says how it feels so difficult, but also knowing that I needed that freedom from that relationship. That's where the chorus
is. Is it easy to write songs like that rather than trying to invent something? If you're doing it from experience, is that a bit easier for you?
I've never invented anything, because I have enough drama in my own life to have enough material for songs. I don't even need to write any more songs, because I have a back catalogue of about 300 or 400 songs. So, you know, that I never write making something up. It's either from something I've seen in someone else's life, or something that's happened to me.
Okay. Feel Free, we'll find Kangaroo Alliance. What, any gigs you want to plug, by the way, while you're here?
Just Oxjam.
Oxjam. Yeah, that's why you're here, isn't it?
That's it. That's the most important one.
I walked into that one.
4:30.
Where?
At the Sound House.
Yeah.
Yeah, which is great sound. The Sound House has fantastic sound.
Yes, it does.
And lights as well.
Yeah.
Did you know the lights? Apparently the lights are from an aircraft, the lights at the back of the stage. The really bright ones.
Wow.
Yeah.
They've got
yeah.
amazing photos of us.
It's not, not a jumbo jet or anything. It's just a little Cessna.
Right, we'll play the track and Kevin's going to take a photo of us to go on our website, Local Music Show with John and Kevin, is it? Something like that?
Our Facebook page, John, is...
I'm never good at things like that.
Is if you do facebook.com/localmusicshow and the number one, then that's our Facebook page. All this is on there and video interviews and everything.
And obviously, this has been recorded and going out a podcast later, so you'll be able to laugh at yourselves later on.
Brilliant. Oh, can't
thank
wait.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Here we
Thanks.
Go. It was good to have the Men Flying Kangaroo Alliance. That's a track from them called Feel Free. We'll talk to somebody from the Demons of Ruby May. Now, Kevin, you sent me this track earlier today, and I've absolutely fallen in love with it. And I tell you what, you released that nationally. It's a sort of sound that will get in the charts for me.
Yeah, I know.
I like it that much.
Well, I think it's rather special, actually. In fact, all the stuff they do is rather special, to be honest.
I think they're on the phone. Shall we speak to them first?
Yeah, let's do that. But Demons of Ruby May, absolutely love their stuff. I don't know what genre you'd call it.
Hello, Demons of Ruby May. Sorry, who's on the phone?
Jonny.
Jonny, how are you doing, Jonny? I was just saying, and you missed it, because me and Kevin are talking.
Hi, Jonny.
He sent me this track earlier by you, and I think it's absolutely brilliant, and I think it should be on national radio.
Who is that?
John Sinclair, how are you doing?
Hi, John Sinclair.
How are you?
Yeah, very well, very well. Good, thank you.
I think that's definitely my track of the week.
Oh, thank you very much.
But tell us about the song itself before we play it. Kind of what was the inspiration behind it? Because there's a great synthesizer in there as well.
Which one was it?
It was Beneath the Surface.
Ah.
Beneath the Surface, Bernard, is our current single at the moment, which we've had out since July. And we're promoting that this Friday at Firebug with some out-of-town bands, a band called Dharma Sunset from Cambridgeshire and another band by the name of Black Mountain Lights from Liverpool, as well as solo artist Luke Walker. Ooh. From Leicester. The song came about from a visit last year to Thailand. I stopped off at Mumbai Airport and came up with some ideas and inspirations for a song, really, around the idea of somebody that I know that is never happy with everything that he has, and he has quite a lot more than most people that I know.
I know what you mean.
And it's kind of a simple song and a simple message, really, that might focus on the things in life that are simple and that you have around you that don't cost anything. And I guess that's the sentiment of the song in its purest form. So yeah, and that kind of stems in a lot of the songs and music that we write, really. Just kind of reflects, well, we try to reflect on its lyrics and something that has meaning, I guess. But
that to me sounds like a lot of what the band are doing at the moment, just keeping it pure and stripping away all the crap and, you know, keeping the basics, saying what matters.
Yeah, I mean, we try not to think about it too much in terms of writing. It's quite an organic process, and yeah, we enjoy what we do, so.
That's the main thing, isn't it? If you're enjoying what you do, it can only be good.
Yes, definitely.
Okay.
Will you guys be coming tomorrow? Not tomorrow, Friday, sorry.
Yeah, definitely. We'll definitely be coming on Friday.
I just want to see you perform this song live, because I've absolutely fallen in love with it, so I'm looking forward to that.
Have you not seen us play live before, John?
Yeah, I have, I think. Weren't you on stage at Glaston Budget? I'm trying to remember. I have seen you recently, but I can't remember what.
They did Strawberry Fields on your stage, actually.
I think Strawberry Fields was the last time, yeah. Yeah, I think so. Anyway, we'll have to leave it there, but thanks for coming on.
No, thanks for having me.
No worries. We're going to go out with Demons of Ruby May, and this is called Beneath the Surface. Thanks very much for coming on, mate.
Thanks, guys. Cheers.
Wanted what he couldn't get. Was a man who hated his own fortune, spending his life living through regret. 'Cause he never realized what's important. Beneath the sea.
Excellent stuff from Demons of Ruby May. Myself and Kevin will be back with the local music show next week, same time, 6 till 7.